Hello friends, good morning, hope you're doing great. Today we'll discuss about the LT throughput analysis and the factors affecting throughput, how to get a better throughput in LT system. We are having a couple of videos earlier explaining how throughput is calculated. So let's go for the next day. So first of all, we need to see how is the radio condition before we check in the throughput. So the required information from radio is the RSRP, the RSRQ and the SINR value. These three are very important. As a radio engineer, you have to ensure we are having good SINR, signal to interference noise ratio, good RSRQ and good RSRP to have a better throughput, because a radio condition greatly impact the throughput in LT system or any other telecommunication system. So I'll say that ranges for you, like SINR greater than 20 dB is the best value considered. So the best throughput we can get if the SINR value is greater than 20 dB. If it is 13 to 20, it's a good value. 0 to 13 is average, and below 0 if we are having the SINR, then God help us, we have very poor RF condition. Secondly, the RSRP values, the best value is greater than minus 80, minus 80 to minus 90 is a good value we can consider. Minus 90 to minus 100 is average. Greater than minus 100 RSRP is a bad condition, RF condition. And the third most crucial information in radio we require is RSRQ. That RSRQ value should be greater than minus 10, which is the best value. And from minus 10 to minus 15 is good. Minus 15 to minus 20 is average, and lower than minus 20 is considered as the worst value or the poor value for RSRQ. So these are the three stuff we need to ensure before we calculate the throughput, or we do any optimization in throughput. The radio should be okay, that is the SINR should be greater than 20 dB, the RSRQ values should be greater than minus 10 dB, and the RSRP should be better than minus 80. The other points which we consider in field measurements, and which is very crucial also to see in terms of throughput optimization, the PCI plan should be okay. The physical cell identities and the planning of PCI should be very intact. There shouldn't be any collision or confusion of PCIs, that we need to ensure. The neighbors also should be planned properly, and because the neighbor RSRP and the serving cell RSRP both plays a very important role when we see the throughput optimization. Then we are having what are the parameters we check during this throughput analysis, the PCI and the neighbor PCIs, the collective or the combined RSRP and SINR, that is serving and others also, maximum downlink throughput, maximum uplink throughput, the TX power. This all play a very vital and important role. There's a very important key parameters when calculating the throughput. The CQI, which is very important again. The CQI values for LT is from 0 to 15, 15 being the best value and 0, 1, 2 being the least values. So if the CQI is good, that means the quality of radio channels and the radio condition is really good. So the next step is the MCS, modulation and coding schemes, which you know, decides which modulation encoding scheme to be used in the next transmission, like should it be PPSK, QPSK, 16 QAM or 64 QAM. Then we have the rank indicators. I'll explain the rank indicator. Then we are having resource block numbers, average resource block numbers for in downlink and uplink both, which plays again very important role. If we are having low number of resource block, we'll have low throughput. If you're having higher resource block, higher number of resource block for downlink and uplink transmission, allocated higher number of resource block, then we'll have better throughput. Then we are having the RRC state. We need to see whether it is connected or not connected, or sync or out of sync state, in sync or out of sync state. Then last but not the least, the tracking area plan also we need to see. The tracking area plan should be okay according to the requirements, and we need to cross verify the tracking area updates in all other technology when we are having a interact PS, you know, or handover to other technology, IRAT handovers. So we need to see the tracking area codes are properly, you know, notified in other technology, and you know, the tracking area code planning should be very intact. So that's all about the parameters we need to check, and the other factors which comes into account when calculating throughput is the modulation schemes, like whether it is BPSK, QPSK, you know, 8PSK, 16 QAM, 32 QAM or 64 QAM. So in different modulation schemes, we are having different bits per symbol transmitted in every subframe. So let's take the example of 64 QAM. We transmit 6 bits per OFDM modulation symbol in LT. So that's the highest level of modulation and highest bits per symbol transmitted in LT system. In other system, I'll tell you, in BPSK we are having 1 bits per symbol transmitted, in QPSK 2 bits per symbol, in 8PSK 3 bits per symbol, in 16 QAM 4 bit per symbol, 32 QAM 5 bit per symbol, and 64 QAM 6 bits per symbol is transmitted, which plays a very important role when calculating throughput. We need to see what kind of modulation scheme or the MCS code is used by seeing the index. The next thing is you know, the rank indicators. Rank indicators are they are 2 bits for 4 cross 4, and for 2 cross 2 MIMO it's 1 bit. In 1 bit we are having just 0 and 1 to transmit to represent rank 1 or rank 2. Rank 1 means the UE is notifying to the NOB or the network that I'm having one antenna which is experiencing good SINR, which means you have to downgrade the transmission to single antenna, not MIMO, because I'm not able to get good SINR in both my antenna port. So that's the UE communicate to the NOB. So if we get a rank 1, we have to downgrade the transmission to single antenna transmission. If we get rank 2, rank 2 means in a 2 plus 2 MIMO, the UE notifies the NOB that I'm having both the antennas experiencing good SINR, so we can now update the transmission from single to MIMO. So we can apply MIMO only if we are getting a rank 2, or you can say in binary bit 1 in the uplink, and we change from single to 2 cross 2 MIMO transmission in the downlink. So that's how rank indicators are very important when considering throughput. Then the indexes, like the MCS index and the transport block size and index, which is again very important. Transport block size means according to the CQI, we map the CQI with a particular MCS, and this MCS is again mapped with a certain transport block size. There is a table wherein we have the number of resource blocks from 0 to 100 and the index of transport block size. So we are having transport block size from 0 to 26. So 26 being the highest transport block size or the index. If you are having the last, that means 26 as a value, it is the highest index of transport block size. And if you are having, let's say, 100 resource blocks, then for 26 and 100 resource block, so there is a table which calculate on which index of the transport block size we are having, how many bits per symbol per millisecond per subframe. So that is again very important. The index of transport block size, or TBS, which is from 0 to 26, which is mapped against 0 to 31 MCS, or the modulation coding schemes. So index of modulation coding schemes from CQI, it's mapped to index of modulation coding schemes, and from modulation and coding schemes, it's again mapped to transport block size, or the index of transport block size. And then we are having the number of resource block, and accordingly we have the throughput calculations. So that's all about the throughput calculation and the factors which affect the throughput. So now I believe you can do a better throughput optimization. So let me summarize what all you need to check when calculating the throughput. Number one is the radio conditions. So I'll bifurcate them, like one is good RSRP, good RSRQ, good SINR. I explained what the range is. Then you need to check number of resource blocks allocated in downlink and uplink for transmission. Then we need to check the CQI values. It should be the highest. It's 15 is the highest value of CQI, which gives good throughput. We should have higher order modulation schemes, 64 com, for which we need to follow the index of MCS, or the modulation and coding schemes, which is from 0 to 31. You should have 31 as the best MCS. Then we are having ITBS, or transport block index, which is from 0 to 26, 26 being the highest, and the number of resource block allocated in downlink and uplink for transmission of user data. So if the highest number we are calculating as 100 resource block, if 20 megahertz is there. So, and last but not the least, the rank indicators, which is the length of rank indicator is 1 bit for 2x2 MIMO and 2 bits for 4x4 MIMO. And in rank indicator for 2x2, we are having just two binary bits, 0 and 1. 0 is the rank 1, and 1 is the rank 2. Rank 1 means the UE communicate to the node B that I'm experiencing good SINR in just one antenna port, so kindly downgrade the transmission from MIMO to single antenna transmission. If it is rank 2 reported by the UE, that means the UE is experiencing good SINR in both the antenna ports of the UE, and which is requesting for a higher order transmission 2x2 MIMO again from single antenna transmission. So again, rank indicators are very important when checking out throughput issues. So the coding rate and the MIMO also plays a very important role during throughput calculation and throughput optimization, because the coding rate, let's say the coding rate, coding efficiency is 50%, that means if the coding rate is 0.5, that means we are sending just half of the bits as user data and half of the bits as protection error correction bits. So throughput again depends on the type of coding used and the MIMO settings also, like whether it's a 2x2 MIMO, 4x4 MIMO or single antenna system. Thank you so much for watching this complete video on throughput calculation and optimization. I hope you can now drive the throughput optimization and analysis end to end in terms of radio or the RF side. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and please do like and comment below the video if you want us to cover some new topics. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye bye.